Welcome to TI Precision Labs. In this series, we're going to discuss DisplayPort, or DP link training. DisplayPort has become a standard for connecting PCs, laptops, and other computers to video monitors. It is also available on video graphics cards, docking stations, projectors, and other computer peripherals. Having a solid understanding of the link training mechanism would help in understanding and debugging common design issues associated with the DisplayPort interface. If you have not watched the first part of this series, What is DisplayPort? Please watch that before continuing this video. For DisplayPort, there are three major components: the main link, the auxiliary or aux channel, and the hot plug detect or HPD. The main link is used for transmission of video and audio. The main link consists of a number of unidirectional serial data channels that operate concurrently. These are commonly referred to as lanes. The aux channel is a half-duplex bidirectional data channel used for control and status information. HPD is a 3.3-volt signal provided by the sink to the source. Let's start with an overview of the DP connection sequence. The sink starts by driving high on the hot plug detect, indicating to the source that there is a display device connected to it. Once the source detects HPD being high, the source reads the sink Enhanced Extended Display Identification, or EDID, through the aux bus. The EDID is a data structure that describes the sync capabilities to the source. The source then reads the sync DisplayPort configuration data, or DPCD, through the aux bus. The DPCD is a data structure that describes the sync link and DSC capabilities to the source. Link training establishes the physical link parameters used for transmission of video and audio over the DP main link. The link training consists of two sequences. The first sequence is the clock recovery. Once the clock recovery sequence is complete, the source will start the channel equalization sequence. Once the link training is complete, and if the video audio content is flagged for content protection, the High Bandwidth Digital Content Protection, or HDCP, authentication protocol is used. Compressed and encrypted video transmission is then initiated through the main link. Now let's take a look at the clock recovery sequence of link training. Please note, this is a general representation and may change depending on the specific source and sync implementation. The purpose of clock recovery is for the sync to recover the source clock from the data stream. The phase and frequency of the sync PLL will be synchronized with the data stream during clock recovery. The source starts to see transmitting the TPS1 data pattern on the main link. The source normally starts signaling with the minimum drive setting, which is voltage swing, preemphasis, and post cursor 2 at level 0. To meet the CR done condition, the sync only sets its CR done bits and its DPCD register when its link CDR unit has maintained the frequency lock. The sync must set the CR done bit for up to 4 lanes in the DPCD register to complete the CR portion of the link training and move on to the channel equalization sequence of link training. Once the source transmits the TPS1 pattern, the source will then check via the aux channel if the source and sync has managed to recover the clock. If the clock has not been recovered, the sync device can request new settings for voltage swing and preemphasis to try for the next iteration. The TPS1 will then be retransmitted, and the source will again check if the sync has managed to synchronize the reference clocks. This behavior will loop until the preemphasis and voltage swing have changed up to 5 times, or until the reference clocks have been synchronized. If changing the voltage swing or preemphasis fails to realize the CR lock, then the source can reduce the link rate or lane count and return the link rate to the value used at the beginning of the CR sequence and repeat. If any of the CR done bits remain unset, even at the reduced bit rate and or the reduced lane count after all the voltage swing values have been tried, the source ends the training without establishing the link, which typically results in a blank screen. Once the CR is completed, the source will start the channel equalization sequence of the link training. In the EQ sequence, the source transmits the TPS2, 3, or 4 data pattern on the main link. The source will also use the drive setting and link configuration from the CR phase to start the EQ training. The source resets the loop count and must wait before reading the link status bits from the sync DPCD registers through the aux bus. If the CR done bits are set, the source will stop transmitting the training pattern to indicate the end of training and then start the transmission of video stream data. If the CR done bit is not set, then the source needs to downshift to the lower link rate or lane count and return to CR. If the link rate or lane count is already at its lowest, then the source ends the link training, which will result in a blank screen. If the CR done bit is set and the EQ done bit is not set, the source needs to read the sync relevant status bits. Unless all status bits are 1, the source must continue to adjust the drive setting according to the request by the sync unless max drive level has been achieved. The minimum loop count on this sequence is 1, while the maximum loop count is 5. The loop count is incremented by 1 on the aux ACK when all the relevant status bits are not being set. When any one or more of the status bits are not 1 in the 6th loop, the source needs to downshift to the next lower data rate or lane count, and then return to the CR sequence. If the link rate or lane count is already at minimum, then the source will end link training without establishing the link, which will result in a blank screen. DisplayPort requires a high-speed interface to support high-resolution video. Maintaining signal integrity for these high-speed signals over the transmission media is very important, but also quite challenging. A redriver or a retimer placed on the main link between the source and the connector, or between the connector and the sink, can help alleviate some of the high-speed design limits. For more detail on a signal conditioner, please refer to the TI Precision Labs presentation, What is a Signal Conditioner? And What is the difference between linear and limited redriver? Since having a signal conditioner helps to improve the DP main link signal quality, we can use the DP link training to help tune the signal conditioner settings. For example, we can tune up and down the signal conditioner setting until the link training fails. This will establish a lower and upper boundary of the signal setting. By choosing a setting in the middle of the boundary, we will then ensure that the signal conditioner has the maximum operating margin. Be sure to visit our E2E support forums at ti.com/E2E, where we can help answer questions about designing with interface technologies. Please also reference previous TIPL videos, like our video on eye diagrams.